This video is integrated pest management for northern corn leaf blight in field corn. My name is Ken Wise. I'm the New York State IPM area educator for field crops and livestock in eastern New York with Cornell University. Northern corn leaf blight has become more of a problem for corn growers in the Northeast. Many plant pathologists agree that the disease has perpetuated because of conservation and no-tillage practices in cornfields to reduce soil erosion. This leaves the past crop residue on the surface and is a host for the fungi. The fungus will overwinter on residue and can infect corn the next season. The spores can be transported by wind over long distances. The blight can locally spread in and between fields on wind-blown spores. If lesions begin before silking, there is a possibility of crop losses. Infections that occur later in the season have less impact on yield. Wet, humid, cool weather helps the fungus establish on the corn plants. It normally occurs later in the season. In recent years, some fields have had yield losses from northern corn leaf blight. The blight shows up as a gray, green, or tan cigar-shaped lesion 1 to 6 inches long. The lesions run parallel to the leaf margin, beginning on the lower leaves and moving up the plant. They may merge and cover most of the leaf surface area. On the underside of the leaf, spores are produced. This appears as a dusty green fuzz. There are currently no specific thresholds for northern corn leaf blight on corn. It is recommended that you scout fields for the disease from the V14 to the R1 stage. The importance is to protect the ear leaf and above during the reproductive stages to prevent yield losses if there is an infection present. It is unclear if there is an economic return to spraying after the R1 stage. If you have an infection that is at or above the ear leaf, you might get an economic return from a fungicide application if the field has good yield potential. Remember, if there is no disease, there is no reason to spray a fungicide. Northern corn leaf blight can be managed through the use of resistant hybrids. You can check with your seed provider on the level of resistance in the hybrids. Planting at the correct time of the season can help in avoiding conditions that favor the disease.